This is a classic inertia trap question on high school exams. Let's take a look. This liquid container has a water tank. There's a bubble in the tank now. If the car suddenly accelerates right, moving forward, which way will the bubble move? Many students and parents said, "Teacher, that's easy, the car moves right. The bubble, due to inertia, will maintain its original state. It will definitely go left. Go stand outside and get 50 whacks before returning to class." Is that logical thinking? Students, this involves a key question. How is inertia related to objects? It relates to mass. So not only does the bubble have inertia, but doesn't the water have inertia too? So which has greater mass? Clearly, water has more mass than the bubble. So whose inertia should we consider first? Consider the water's inertia first. So because of water's inertia, when the car suddenly moves right, it wants to maintain its original state. It will tend to move backward. Its inertia is greater. It's the bigger force. What it does matters. So as it moves backward, what happens to the bubble? Your mass is small. Your inertia is small. You just go with the flow. So when water moves back, doesn't it push the bubble forward? So the bubble should move right. Energy hero. Did you learn that? Focus on energy physics mastery.